ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। सो हरि ओम, सल्यूटेशंस टू ऑल। वी आर ऑन लेसन 18 टुडे। सो लेसन 17 वी सॉ द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ महावाक्यस विच आर देयर। व्हाट इज अ महावाक्य? अ महावाक्य इज दैट विच इंडिकेट्स द वननेस ऑफ द जीव एंड ईश्वर और जीव एंड ब्रह्मन। जीव ब्रह्म ऐक्य इज वॉट द महावाक्य इंडिकेट्स। वी सॉ फोर टाइप्स ऑफ महावाक्य, फोर मेजर महावाक्यस। प्रज्ञानम ब्रह्म, अयम आत्मा ब्रह्म, तत्वमसि, अहम ब्रह्मास्मि। सो दिस महावाक्य टेल्स अस व्हाट? दैट द जीव एंड ईश्वर दे आर having different upadhis. Jiva is individual body, mind, intellect illumined by consciousness. Ishvara is total body, mind, intellect illumined by consciousness. Now from the upadhi bhed, both of them are different. Like the wave is a small one wave with limited water, but the ocean is all pervading. It is huge. Ocean is huge amount of water. So from the standpoint of ocean and wave, they cannot be seen. Same way from the standpoint of upadhis, the jiva and ishvara, they are not same. But from the standpoint of consciousness, they both are the same. Like from the standpoint of water, the wave and the ocean, both are the same. There is no difference. Water in the wave and the water in the ocean, both are one and the same. And hence it is that the Mahavakya indicates this oneness from the consciousness standpoint. Now we will take this most famous Mahavakya, Tat, Tvam, Asi, and see why we are taking such a meaning. So the analysis has to be done of this Mahavakya, Tat, Tvam, Asi. That thou art. So this Mahavakya Tattvamasi is found in the Chandogya Upanishad, which is in Samaveda, in the 6th chapter. So in this, the great saint Uddalak Rishi, he has sent his son Shvetaketu for studying to the Gurukul. After staying there for about 12 years or so, when the sun is returning, from the way the sun returns, the Rishi, Uddalak Rishi, understood that he has not known the truth. So Uddalak Rishi asks him when he comes, that did you find out the truth? What is the truth of the individual, the universe, the creator? What is the truth? Did you find out the truth? So that's the purpose of education. But the boy answers with a lot of attitude and arrogance. He said, if my teacher knew, my teacher would have taught. So the Rishi asks him, did you ask for this knowledge? And the boy realizes his mistake. And he says, no, no, I didn't ask. And so the Rishi, when he has asked this question, Uddalak suddenly realized, oh, what a mistake I made. I studied so many things, but I didn't find out the truth. And spiritual knowledge is such that when we ask, then it is given. The demand has to be there. So it is that he becomes humble and he asks his father, please teach me what is the truth. And the teacher tells him, now he takes up the role of the teacher. So as a teacher, he tells him, Tat Tvam Asi, that you are that absolute truth. You are not this body, mind and intellect. Now Shvetaketu wants to know more details. So the master, Uddalak Rishi, he does 9 different experiments. And at the end of each experiment, he tells him, Tat Tvam Asi. For example, he shows a banyan seed. And he says, what is this? He says, this is a seed of a banyan tree. So he asks the student, Shvetaketu, can you see the whole tree in this? He says, no. But is the tree there in this or not? He said, yes. So in what form is it there? It is in the unmanifest form. So just like the seed has the entire tree in the unmanifest form, in the same way, the supreme truth is there in our own heart, but right now is unmanifest. And you are that truth. Tat Tvam Asi. Then he takes one glass of water, mixes salt in that, and he tells Shvetaketu, take the water from the top and drink it. How does it taste? It is salty. Take the water from the middle. How does it taste? Says salty. Take the water from the bottom. How does it taste? Salty. So he says, just like the salt pervades this entire water, the truth pervades the whole universe. And you are that truth. Tat Tvam Asi. You see, nowadays people talk about learning should not be rote learning. It should not be classroom type only. It should be practical. It should be with demonstration. Our ancient Gurukul systems had all that. And here the teacher is teaching Shvetaketu with all these demonstrations. So many different experiments he does. And he teaches him. So through 9 experiments, the conclusion of each experiment is that thou art. You are that absolute truth. You are not this body, mind and intellect. So now this Mahavakya, Tat Tvam Asi, let us analyze this. So the word, the sentence is made up of 3 words. Tat, Tvam and Asi. So Tat means that. It's a third person singular pronoun. Tat. Tvam is second person singular pronoun meaning you. So Tat means that. Tvam means you. And Asi is the verb. Asi means you are. So this Asi indicates the oneness. That you are. Tat Tvam Asi. So Asi is like equal to. So Tat is equal to Tvam. You are that. Now when we say this, you are that, we already learned this, that every word, every sentence where we cannot take the direct meaning, we have to take the indicative meaning. So what is the direct meaning of the word Tat? Tat means that, Ishvara. So the literal meaning of the word Tat is all the body, mind, intellect put together. So gross body, subtle body, causal body. The total gross body, subtle body, causal body put together, illumined by consciousness. That is the literal meaning of the word Tat. You see that the example we had, equation we had done last time. That Tat or Ishvara is equal to total BMI plus consciousness. And what is that consciousness? Existence, consciousness, bliss, Sachidanand. So total body, mind, intellect, which is macrocosm conditioning, plus Sachidanand Atma, Sachidanand principle, Sachidanand consciousness, that is the Ishvara. Now, when we say this is the Ishvara, literal meaning of the word Ishvara is the total BMI plus consciousness. What does that mean? That Ishvara is omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient, all those qualities Ishvara has. Sarvajnyatva, Sarveshwaratva, Sarvantaryamitva, that's the quality of Ishvara. And when we use the word Tat, means that, so we always use the word that to show something other than us. That computer, that phone, that table, that means not I, separate from me. That. So we say that Lord, that Ishvara. Why we say that Ishvara, Paroksha? Because that Ishvara is the creator, sustainer, destroyer of the world. I am not creator, sustainer, destroyer. I am a part of this world. I am a jiva in this world. So that Ishvara created the world. So we always use the word that to indicate something other than ourselves. And hence in Vakya Vritti, Shankaracharya ji says that the literal meaning of the word tat is this. Mayopadhi jagad yonihi sarvajnyatvadi lakshanah paroksha balasatyadhyatmakastat padabhidah parokshasya shabalah satyadhyatmakah tat padabhidah. Mayopadhi jagad yoni, one who has created this entire universe by the force of his maya, Ishvara is that. So we remember the equation. Brahman plus Maya is equal to Ishvara. So Brahman, using a power of Maya, takes up the upadhi of Ishvara and becomes a Srishtikarta. Sarvajnyatvadi lakshana. And what are his qualities? Sarvajna, Sarveshwaratva, Sarvantaryamitva, Sarvasrashtratva, Sarvabhoktratva. All these are his qualities, that he is omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient, all these qualities. Paroksha, paroksha shabalaha. We consider that Ishvara as separate from oneself and known only through some as someone else, not as I. So we know Ishvara as that God who is a creator. Atma padadi abhidaha. So this is the satyadhyatmakaha tat padabhidaha. This is the literal meaning of the word tat. So now Ishvara has maya upadhi. Ishvara is the srishtikarta. Ishvara is the one who is known as other than me. So the word tat means this. What does the word tvam mean? Literal meaning of the word tvam means the jiva, means you and I. So what is this jiva? The individual body, mind, intellect, microcosm conditioning, plus Sachidananda Swarup Atma. That is the jiva. Existence, consciousness, bliss, plus microcosm conditioning is the jiva. Now, what are the qualities of this jiva? The qualities of the jiva are opposite to this Ishvara. If Ishvara is sarvajna, jiva is alpajna. Ishvara knows everything, jiva knows very little. Ishvara is sarvavyapi, jiva is alpavyapi. Ishvara is sarvashaktiman, jiva is alpashaktiman. Ishvara is experienced as other than I, but jiva is experienced as I, aparoksha. And these are opposite qualities. So in Vakya Vritti, Shankaracharya ji says, this is the meaning of the word tvam. Literal meaning, huh? This is. The literal meaning of the word tvam is alambanataya abhati. Yo asmat pratyaya shabdayoho antakkarana sambhinna bodha satvam padabhidaha. So who is this jiva now? the literal literal meaning of the word tvam is this alambanataya abhati antakarana sambhinnaha, that which is conditioned by this subtle body. When we say subtle body, it also includes this gross body, causal body also. So the jiva is this atma reflecting in this subtle body, appearing to be limited. Antakarana sambhinna. And alambanataya abhati. This word I is known as the object of the idea. Meaning what? Alambanataya abhati yo asmat pratyaya shabdayoho. This I, this jiva, small I, is the object of the real I. This Atma Chaitanya is the real I, which is reflecting in this subtle body. That real I becomes small I when reflecting in this subtle body. Like the big sun reflecting in this bucket of water appears as a small reflection. Now compared to that big sun, this reflection is so small. Same way that pure consciousness reflecting in this subtle body appears as a small I. The Sakshi in me observes that I. Hence this I becomes the object. So this small I, which is limited by this equipment of gross, subtle, causal body, is the literal meaning of the word tvam. So literal meaning of the word tvam is jiva, literal meaning of the word tat is Ishvara, and both of them have a completely opposite quality. Ishvara is sarvajna, sarvashaktiman, sarvavyapi, experienced as paroksha. Jiva is alpajna, alpashaktiman, alpavyapi, experienced as aparoksha. Now the word asi means equal to, identity. How can this jiva and this Ishvara become one when the upadhis have complete contradiction? Like it is saying, like the wave and the ocean are one. A wave is so small, ocean is so huge. How can wave and ocean be one? So here it is that Shankaracharya ji in his Vivek Chudamani gives different examples to show the difference between the Ishvara and Jiva. So verse 242, one line is quoted here in the material. Khadvon khadyota bhanvo riva raja bhrityayoho kupambu rashyoho paramanu mervoho. So these are four examples. What are the four examples? Khadyota bhanvo riva, like the glowworm and the sun. Khadyota is glowworm, bhanu is the sun. Khadyota bhanvo riva. Now what is the opposite characteristics? You see, glowworm has limited light, sun is unlimited light. So the effulgence wise, there is no comparison between a glowworm and the sun. Even if we put countless glowworms together, it will not match the brilliance of the sun. So how glowworm and sun are opposite, jiva and Ishvara are completely opposite. Jiva has limited knowledge, Ishvara is unlimited knowledge. Then the next one is Rajabhrityayoho, like the king and the servant. The king is the controller, servant is the controlled. Ishvara is the controller of the whole creation. Jiva does not have control over even on his own body, mind, intellect. So how can this jiva and that Ishvara be one? So first one is from the standpoint of knowledge and effulgence, they both are opposite. Second is from the standpoint of power, Shakti, control. Ishvara controls everything. Ishvara controls his Maya also. Jiva is under the control of Maya. Jiva does not have any control on the BMI. Then Kupambu Rashyoho. the well, the water in the well, and the water in the ocean. No comparison at all. Water in the well here is the example for limited temporary pleasure that the jiva experiences. And water in the ocean here is symbolic of the unlimited bliss that Ishvara experiences. Jiva experiences mixture of pleasure and pain. Ishvara does not have pain at all. It beyond pleasure and pain that unlimited bliss Ishvara experiences. And Paramanu Mervoho, a small atom, and Meru, huge mountain. What is the limitation? What is the example here for? This atom is very small. Meru is huge. This is pervasiveness. Atom is small, means one particle is small. And this Meru is such a huge thing in size. In the same way, Ishvara is all pervasive like the Meru, and Jiva is one small atom, limited pervasiveness. Now this is the contradiction between Jiva and Ishvara from the Vachyartha standpoint. From the literal meaning standpoint, when we see the conditionings, then yes, they both are completely opposite. They cannot be equal. So when the literal meaning of a word, of a sentence cannot be used, it doesn't make any sense, then we have to try and use the indicative meaning, which is called as Lakshyartha. So Vachyartha is the literal meaning. Lakshyartha is the indicative meaning. So now this Vachyartha, which is there, we saw that individual BMI plus consciousness equal to Jiva. Total BMI plus consciousness equal to Ishvara. So from Vachyartha standpoint, they are not same. Now, then what we have to do? We have to take the Lakshyartha. What is the indicative meaning? So for Lakshyartha, many times we use that in our daily life also. So when we say he roared like a lion. Now he roared like a lion means what? Not that literally he roared like a lion. That's a simile. We are taking indicative meaning that he was very brave, he was very courageous, and he fearlessly spoke the truth. That's the indicative meaning. Same way traditionally in the in Vedanta we give example. Manchaha kroshanti. Manchaha kroshanti means what? The galleries are noisy. Now, what is the meaning of galleries are noisy? Galleries are inert. There are only chairs there. How can galleries be noisy? What it means is that people who are sitting in the galleries, they are making noise. So when the indicative meaning is taken, the indicative meaning has to be taken in such a way that there is something connected with the word meaning. It cannot be something absolutely unconnected. So this Vachyartha, when it is not applicable, we use the Lakshyartha. But the Lakshyartha is not unconnected to Vachyartha. It is something connected to Vachyartha. What does that mean? When we say galleries are noisy, what is the meaning? The people who are sitting in the galleries are making the noise. Hence the galleries are noisy. It is not people sitting somewhere in a factory or a bank of a river or in some mountain who are noisy. It is not an unconnected meaning. The meaning is connected to the Vachyartha. So the Lakshyartha in some way is connected to the Vachyartha, which is what Shankaracharya explains in the Vakyavritti verse 47. Manantara virodhetu mukhyarthasya parigrahe mukhyarthena vina bhute pratitir lakshanochyate. What does this mean? Mana antara virodhetu mukhyarthasya parigrahe. When there is inconsistency in accepting the direct meaning, mukhyarthena vina bhute, we have to take a indicative meaning connected नॉट अनकनेक्टेड. मुख्यार्थ है ना, मुख्यार्थ है ना विना भूते प्रतीतिर लक्षण उच्यते. द इंडिकेटिव मीनिंग कनेक्टेड टू द डायरेक्ट मीनिंग इज वॉट इज कंसिडर्ड एज द लक्ष्यार्थ. लक्षणा इज दिस कॉल्ड लक्षण उच्यते. सो लक्ष्यार्थ और लक्षणा बोथ मीन द सेम थिंग. वी कॉल इट लक्षणा वृत्ति और लक्षणा. लक्ष्यार्थ और लक्षणा बोथ मीन्स इंडिकेटिव मीनिंग. सो द इंडिकेटिव मीनिंग मस्ट बी कनेक्टेड टू द डायरेक्ट मीनिंग. इट कैन नॉट बी इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द डायरेक्ट मीनिंग. सो नाउ इन वेदांत वी हैव थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ लक्षणा. वन इज कॉल्ड जहति लक्षणा, अदर इज कॉल्ड अजहति लक्षणा, एंड थर्ड इज कॉल्ड भागत्याग लक्षणा. Now each of these we will see what is the meaning of this, and then we will see the application of this in Tattvamasi. Because Tattvamasi literal meaning is not making sense. Jiva and Ishvara cannot be one. So we have to take indicative meaning. Now to take indicative meaning, there are three types of indicative meanings which are possible. We have to choose which one will be applicable in this case of Tattvamasi. The first type of indicative meaning is called Jahati Lakshana. Jahati Lakshana means what? Ha, the word Jahati comes from Dhatu called Ha. Ha means Ha Jahati. Ha means to drop. So in Jahati Lakshana, what will we do? We will drop the literal meaning. Sorry, we will drop the meaning of the word completely. And take something connected to that. Remember, not unconnected. The literal meaning of the word has to be dropped and take something fully dropped and take something connected to this. We will see that example here. The example given here is a person wants to, person is searching for a hamlet. A hamlet is called Ghoshaha in Sanskrit. A hamlet where there are a few huts, there are some cows, dogs, some people, etc. who are staying. This person is searching for a hamlet. He goes and asks somebody, where is this hamlet? For example, Rampur. Rampur is the hamlet, Ghoshaha. Rampur Ghoshaha Kutra Asti. Where is this Rampur Ghosh? So that person replies, Gangayam Rampur Ghoshaha. On the Ganga is a Rampur Ghosh. Now, if you say the literal word, if we understand the literal meaning of this, Gangayam Ghosha, it means the hamlet is on the Ganges. How can the hamlet be on the Ganges? Ganges is a river which is continuously flowing. So we can't understand that. Literally, the word Ganga, Gangayam, means on the Ganga. Ghosha means the hamlet. Hamlet is on the Ganga. Now, it makes no sense to say that Hamlet is on the Ganga because it is incomprehensible. How can Hamlet be on the Ganga? So what we have to do? We have to eliminate the meaning of the word Ganga completely and understand the word Tire, meaning on the banks. So when he says Hamlet is on the Ganges, he actually means Hamlet is on the banks of the Ganges. So we have removed the word Ganga fully. Have we taken some other connection meaning, connected meaning, other meaning? No, we have taken a connected meaning. The banks which are of Ganga. So on the banks of Ganga is this. So Ganga word fully eliminated. Tire word is understood and that Tire is connected to Ganga. This is called Jahati Lakshana, which is what Brahmalina Muni explains in this Vedanta Sudha. Shakyartham yatra santyajya tat sambandhitaya paraha artha pratiyate tatra jahati lakshana mata. What is Jahati Lakshana? Shakyartha yatra santyajya. When the word totally gives up the literal meaning, तत्संबंधितया परः, but something connected to that word is taken, which is implied by that word. Artha pratiyate tatra jahati lakshana mata. This is called the jahati lakshana. Like we gave this example, Ganga word gone completely, the word tire is used, and the person understands, oh, the hamlet which is on the banks of this Ganga, that is this place, Rampur. So this is called as jahati lakshana. Now this jahati lakshana is, this applicable in Tattvamasi? We say no, jahati lakshana is not applicable in Tattvamasi, because you cannot remove completely the meaning of tat and tvam, because tat is equal to individual BMI, sorry, total BMI plus consciousness, and tvam is equal to individual BMI plus consciousness. Can we completely negate this definition of tat and tvam? No, we cannot completely negate. So jahati lakshana is not admissible, because the contradiction is only in the upadhi, in the BMI, individual and total, but consciousness is the same, so we cannot use jahati lakshana. In jahati lakshana we drop completely the whole meaning, like gangayam ghoshah, in that the word Ganga, we reject the word Ganga fully and we take the another word called tire. Now the meaning of tat, can I reject fully? I cannot reject. Nor the meaning of tvam I can reject fully. And I cannot take something else, because the problem is not in the whole expression. The problem is only in a part. So entirely if I reject, then the jiva and ishvara aitya cannot be established at all, because consciousness is same in both. So I cannot reject completely this part, tat and tvam. So jahati lakshana is not applicable. Then comes ajahati lakshana. What is this ajahati lakshana? In jahati lakshana, we completely reject the meaning. In ajahati lakshana, we don't reject, we add. So if the mother says, don't allow the dog to come near the food, the literal meaning of the word is, the literal meaning of the sentence is very clear, don't allow the dog to come near the food. But there is also an implied meaning in this. And what is the implied meaning? Don't allow cat, crow, or any other animal also to come near it. So the meaning dog is not rejected, but we add cat also, crow also, by implication. Here the son says, you only told me not to allow the dog to come, but if a cat came and ate, what can I do? That's the foolishness. So mother would say, don't allow a dog to come near the food. By implication, it means any other creature, meaning protect that food. So the meaning of the word dog is not rejected like we do in jahati, but the other animals are added to it. That is called ajahati. So here the Vedant Sudha Brahmalin Muni says, Vachyartha sahitam yatra tat sambandhitaya punaha visheshartha parijnanam ajahal lakshanatusa. Now again remember, in this also what is added is connected to that word dog, meaning no other animal. Dog is animal, so no other animal or creature must come there. It's not something absolutely unconnected. Same way in here also in Lakshanavarti, Vachyartha Sahitam Yatra, along with the Vachyartha, Tat Sambandhitaya Punaha, something connected to that is added. Visheshartha is added. Parijnanam Ajahal Lakshanatusa. That is called ajahat lakshana, where I did not drop something. Jahat means to drop, jahati. Ajahati lakshana means don't drop, add something connected to the word. Now traditional example given for that is Shono Dhavati, red runs. What is the meaning of red runs? How can red run? So these red runs cannot understand. Literal meaning doesn't make sense. Red runs, how can redness run? It's just a color. So without rejecting the word red, we add another word, which is horse. Shonaha Dhavati. When we say red runs, the word shona is red. To that we add horse, ashwaha. Shono ashwaha dhavati. Red horse runs. So when you say red runs, it means red horse runs. So we did not reject the word red, but we added the word horse. This is called ajahati lakshana. Now, how this is applicable in Tattvamasi? Can we add anything in Tat? No, we cannot add anything in Tat or Tvam to make them equal. How much ever we add anything in Tvam, will it become equal to Tat? No. This individual body, mind, intellect, how much ever you add in this individual BMI, can it become equal to the total? How much ever you pump water into one wave, can it become one with the whole ocean? It's not possible. So there is no question of adding anything to make them equal. There is no question of dropping completely the meaning to make them equal. So then what to do? How can they become equal? Which is the third lakshana vritti, which is bhagatyaga lakshana. Bhagatyaga means retain one part and reject the other part. Bhaga, retain. Tyaga, drop. Meaning drop one portion. So what is the example? Saha ayam deva dattaha. That's the traditional example. Saha ayam deva datta means this is that Devadatta. What does this mean? So for example, I meet Devadatta here in Mumbai, and this Devadatta has mustache, he has beard, he has long hair, he's wearing some western clothes, some t-shirt and some jeans and some Reebok shoes, and then Ray-Ban glasses. Now this is the Devadatta I met in Mumbai. But I noticed that he has a long nose. He has one mole on the, forehead. I noticed that. Now, I go to Tirupati. And I'm standing there in the line. And I suddenly see one man who is wearing dhoti, who has shaved his head, shaved the beard, shaved the mustache. But I recognize the long nose and the mole on the forehead. So suddenly I recognize, hey, this is Devadatta. But all my family members are very stunned. Huh? That Devadatta had mustache, beard, long hair. This fellow is bald, no mustache, no beard, no hair. That fellow is western clothes, this fellow is Indian clothes. How is he same? Say, hey, you remove the conditioning. But the mole and the long nose in that Devadatta is the same in this Devadatta also. So you reject the western clothes and Indian clothes. You reject the beard and mustache and bald head and clean shape. The individual who is there is one and the same. In the same way, Saha Ayam Devadattaha. This Devadatta of Tirupati. Ayam Devadatta, this Devadatta of Tirupati is Saha, that Devadatta of Mumbai. You remove Mumbai, you remove Tirupati, you remove the differences in their appearance, but the person is one and the same. So we retain the person, we remove the conditionings, which is what we are doing here in Tattvamasi. We know the equation of Tattvamasi, that Tattvamasi means individual body, mind, intellect plus consciousness is Tvam. total body mind intellect plus consciousness is tat. Now in both these equations, what should I do? I should reject what is not applicable. The individual body mind intellect is an illusion. Total body mind intellect also is an illusion. If you reject that part, then consciousness equal to consciousness, jiva equal to Ishvara, hence tat is equal to tvam. Simple. So this bhagatyaga lakshana is defined by Brahmalin Muni in this way: yatraikamsham parityajya aparamsho grihethasa bhagatyaga tu samprokta jahatyajahati tatha. So this bhagatyaga also is called jahadajahar lakshan, because it's a combination of dropping and retaining. Yatra ekamsham parityajya, only one part is dropped. Aparamsho grihate atha sa, the second part is retained. One part is dropped, one part is retained. This is called bhagatyaga. Bhaga is retained, bhaga is dropped. So that way in Tattvamasi, when we say Tat is equal to Tvam, then the Vachyartha of Tat is Ishvara, Vachyartha of Tvam is Jiva, not applicable. They are not same. But when we say Lakshyartha, then Ishvara has total BMI and consciousness. Jiva has individual BMI and consciousness. Now we all know that individual BMI is an appearance, it is not real, it's an illusion. As long as we are identified with it, it appears real to us. Otherwise it's an illusion. This we have done earlier when we did the Panchakosha Vivek. That time we learned this, that Panchakoshas are not me, three bodies are not me, three states of consciousness are not me, I am that Atma. What is the definition of Atma we had learned? Panchakoshatita san avasthatraya sakshi sthula sukshma karana shariyad vyatiriktaha sachidananda swarupasan. So that which is not the BMI, which is beyond the three bodies, beyond the five koshas, beyond the three states, of the nature of sachidanand, that is the Atma. So when we say negate individual BMI, where is this negation happening? It is not happening on paper. In the seat of contemplation, Nididhyasan, this also we have done earlier, Shravan, Manan, Nididhyasan, on the Mahavakya when I do, then I withdraw from the BMI, from individual BMI when I learn to withdraw my attention, contemplate on Sachidananda Swarup Atma, then what happens? I realize that, hey, I am not the BMI at all. The BMI gets falsified, negated. When this BMI gets negated, that sthiti is called samadhi avastha. Person is in the state of samadhi, where the buddhi has become saman. It has got absorbed in the self, samam brahma. That jiva bhav which was there, that is gone. When jivatva goes, ishvaratva also goes. This is called negating ishvara. So jiva negated will automatically negate ishvara. Will automatically negate the Jagat also. So Jiva gone, Jagat gone, Ishvara gone. What remains? Sachidananda Swarup Atma alone remains. That is a non-dual absolute truth. This is called Tat Tvam Asi. In this way, Tat and Tvam are same from the Lakshyartha standpoint, and in Lakshyartha also we use the Bhagatyaga Lakshana, where we retain the part which is real. What is real? Consciousness is real in both. What is illusory or unreal? Total BMI of Ishvara and individual BMI of Jiva. Now, do I have to reject the total BMI of Ishvara? No. I cannot do that. I cannot destroy the world. I cannot destroy the total BMI to realize oneness. What do I have to do? Should I destroy my BMI? No, I cannot destroy this body, mind, intellect. I have to only go beyond the false identification that I am this body, mind, intellect. So in this context, when I do the श्रवण मनन निधिध्यासन एंड आई डिटैच फ्रॉम दिस बीएमआई. निधिध्यासन इज दैट डिटैच फ्रॉम द बीएमआई एंड असर्ट द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ. मनोबुद्धि अहंकार चित्तानि नाहम न च श्रोत्र जिह्वे न च घ्राण नेत्रे न च व्योम भूमिर्न तेजो न वायु. आई एम नॉट द मन बुद्धि चित्त अहंकार. आई एम नॉट द फाइव सेंसेस. आई एम नॉट द फाइव एलिमेंट्स. देन हु एम आई? चिदानंद रूप शिवोहम शिवोहम. दिस साइमल्टेनियस नेगेशन एंड असर्शन व्हेन आई कीप डूइंग द फॉल्स आइडेंटिफिकेशन दैट आई एम दिस बीएमआई विल ड्रॉप. दैट इज कॉल्ड नेगेशन. When this false identification with the BMI drops of the jiva, of the tvam, the total BMI of tat also will drop. Then what will remain? Tvam is equal to consciousness. Tat is equal to consciousness. So consciousness equal to consciousness. Tvam is equal to tat. Hence proved. So this is proved mathematically, but this is what has to be done in the sadhana. Detached from the BMI, which every day happens to us unconsciously, in the state of deep sleep, we withdraw from the body, mind, intellect. So when we withdraw from BMI, is there a creator? There is no creator. Is there a creation? There is no creation. Is there an individual? There is no individual. Now this is happening every night in the state of deep sleep. This is what we have to do consciously in the sadhana. Detach from the individual BMI. When I drop the attachment to the individual BMI, total BMI also disappears. Ishvara Upadhi gone, Jagat Upadhi gone, Jiva Upadhi gone. What remains? Sat, Chit, Anand. So the Atma in me. Again, I am using the word in me because of limitation of language. There is no other choice. The self here is the self everywhere. That's the realization of the master. The realization is not that now I have realized and you all are deluded people. There is no you at all. There is only one I, Supreme Truth, which is manifesting as all this. So the Mahatma's experience is this non-dual Brahman. That there is only one Brahman. And that Brahman alone is appearing as all this. So the person lives in the vision of Advaita. All psychological divisions and discrimination gone. Person lives in unconditional love, absolute peace, tireless service. There is no selfishness, no ego, nothing. And hence, this is what it is, that Tattvamasi Mahavakya helps us to establish the identity of Jiva with Brahman. In the same way, the other three Mahavakyas also, Ayam Atma Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, Prajnanam Brahma, in all these also, we have to take the Lakshyartha. We cannot take the Vachyartha. Literal meaning we cannot take. We have to take the Lakshyartha. And then out of the Lakshyartha, we have to choose which of the three, Jahati Lakshana, Ajahati Lakshana, or Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Which of the three is applicable? Once we see, then we apply it, and then we realize, oh, this statement means this. From the Lakshyartha standpoint, it indicates Atman, which is the self in me, and Brahman, which is the self in the whole universe, is one and the same. So this is lesson number 18, and this shows the absolute oneness of Jiva and Brahma. So for today we will stop here. If there are any questions that you have, then you are welcome to ask. Unmute your mic and then ask the question. No questions. Okay. So we will continue next week. But I would suggest please read the 17 and 18 lesson properly, because this oneness of the self is indicated in both, oneness of the Jiva and Brahma is indicated in this lesson number 17 and 18 properly. This one has to master well. then one knows why Tattvamasi tells us the oneness. Because there are many other interpretations in which we can get confused. For example, when we say Tat Tvam Asi, so Tat, as we saw, is a pronoun. So the elaboration of this Tat in another standpoint is Tasya Tvam Asi, that you belong to God. Meaning, the Vishishta Advaita standpoint, that you are a part of God. Or Dvaita standpoint, that you are belonging to the Lord. Lord is the master, you are his servant. Now, Tattvamasi does not mean Tasyatvamasi. Why it does not mean Tasyatvamasi? And why it means only this? So when we apply this Jahati, Ajahati and Bhagatyaga Lakshana, then we understand that this is the meaning. Because both the word Tat and Tvam are in Samanadhikaran. They are equal. In Tasya Tvam, one becomes bigger, other becomes smaller. That is the interpretation people have given. So when we understand this Vedantic interpretation properly, then we understand that Tattvamasi indicates the oneness of Jiva and Ishvara from the standpoint of consciousness. And that's the ultimate truth, because till I don't realize that oneness, the sense of incompleteness doesn't go. And hence it is that this lesson one must read properly, that why this type of Lakshana Vritti is applicable, why Jahati is not applicable, why Ajahati is not applicable, how only Bhagatyaga is applicable, and through that come to the firm conviction. See, the objective of this whole thing is not a mathematical or a intellectual understanding, okay, Jiva equal to Ishvara. It means I am that pure consciousness, which is the self, and that same self is appearing as the whole universe. This division between Jiva, Jagat and Ishvara is Mithya. There is no reality to this. So once I get intellectually convinced that yes, I am that pure consciousness, I am not this body, mind, intellect, through proper reflection, then I have to learn to contemplate on the Mahavakya, Tattvamasi, that how I am that pure consciousness, Chidananda Rupa, Shivoham, Shivoham, I am not this BMI at all. So the objective is this, to help us to do Nididhyasana. With a quiet, single-pointed mind, I must do Nididhyasana on the Lakshyartha of this Tattvamasi and detach from the individual BMI by asserting again and again who I am and what I am not. Then this intuitive knowledge arises that yes, I am that pure consciousness, the pure aham I come to realize. Right now this aham is identified with the BMI, so I don't know who am I truly. So the process is to do sadhana, Vedantic sadhana. It is not an intellectual gymnastics that we are doing. We may use logic, we may use different methods given here of Bhagatyaga, Jahati, Ajahati, all those. That is only to give clarity. Once the clarity is there, conviction is there, then one has to start contemplating and realize the truth. So that's where we will stop for today. And next class, we will continue at the venue. In the meanwhile, we have Navaratri starting from this Sunday. So wish you all a very happy Navaratri, and may the grace of Maha Durga, Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati be with all of us. And we generally worship Durga ji for the first 3 days, so that she destroys our tamoguna. We worship Lakshmi ji for the next 3 days so that she helps us to endow our mind with values and virtues, sadhan chatushtaya. And then we worship Mother Saraswati last 3 days, that may she bless us with self-knowledge, so that on the Vijayadashmi day, when Ravan is killed, the ahankar is dropped. That is the real victory. The real victory of human life is dropping of the ego and realizing this oneness of jiva with Ishvara. So may the Supreme Mother bless us with this knowledge of the oneness. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.